Hello there, this is JP Eustachio of ME21, and this is Basic Electronics Engineering Experiment Vlogs. So, let's go!
Let's begin now.
So for this video, I'm going to discuss this. My experiment 3, which is diode application, rectification and oscilloscope familiarization. So here are the objectives. First is to become familiar with the functions and uses of an oscilloscope. Second is to distinguish the difference between an RMS peak and peak-to-peak values of an analog signal. Third is to distinguish between a half-wave rectification and full-wave rectification. Fourth is to measure the DC voltage converted from an AC input signal. And last is to learn how to use a multi-tap transformer. And here are the equipment and components. 1 voltometer or VOM, 1 oscilloscope, 4 1N4001 rectifier diodes, 1 multi-tap transformer, 1 kilo ohm load resistor, and 1 breadboard, alligator clips, and connecting wires. And you know the drill, since it's online, we're gonna use the multi-simulator, which is this. And in this experiment, there are 3 given figures. Figures 1, 2, and 3. Here is figure 1. Here is figure 2. And here is figure 3. And I simulated the circuit here in Multisim. Here. So, here are the procedures. Procedure 1. Oscilloscope familiarization. The first step is to connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope to the 0 terminal and the 6 volt terminal of the multi-tap transformer. So let's go to the multi-simulator. So since this is just, we are going to simulate the circuit, we can ignore the transformer and straight manipulate the VRMS to 6 VRMS to straightly collect the data needed for procedure 1. So, as said in procedure 1, first step is to connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope to the 0 terminal and the 6 volt terminal of the multi-tap transformer. Or you just straight do it like this. Channel A behind the diode, and the other clip is connected to the ground. And the second procedure is to draw the figure that will appear on the screen of the oscilloscope on the space provided on part 5. Adjust the voltage per division and time per division until you can have a better vision of the waveform. Third step, to determine the RMS, the peak value, and the peak-to-peak value of the waveform using the oscilloscope. Answer the questions in part 5. And here is what I gathered from the multi-sim. The RMS value that I gathered is 6 volts. The peak value is 8.471 volts. And the peak-to-peak value is 16.929 volts. Here are the questions that I have answered. What type of waveform appeared? What can you observe on the results above? The type of waveform that appeared from the oscilloscope is a sine wave. As observed from the simulation, both full and half waves were shown. The output terminal showed the full wave, while the input terminal showed the half wave. Second question. Try increasing and decreasing the setting of the voltage per division. What do you observe? As I increase the settings of the voltage per division, the waveforms become shorter, and as I decrease its value, it becomes longer, vice versa. Try increasing and decreasing the setting of the time per division. What do you observe? When increased or decreased, it showed the voltages in the whole part of the wave. Fourth question. Exchange the terminals of the oscilloscope. What happened? Is it expected? Channel A recorded the half wave from the output. Then channel B recorded the full wave from the input. They just exchanged results. The result is expected. And let's go to procedure 2. Procedure 2. Half-wave rectification. First step is to connect the circuit in figure 1. Connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope between the input terminal while channel 2 at the output terminal. 3. Draw the waveforms on the space provided in part 5. Fourth step. Measure the peak input voltage and the peak output voltage. Make adjustments on V division and T division if necessary. Fifth step. Measure the DC voltage using the analog BOM. Measure the input and the output frequency of the circuit. Try reversing the diode terminals and observe what will happen on the output. So, let's go to multi-simulator. As said, in the procedure, first is the we should connect the circuit in figure 1. Second is to connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope between the input terminals while channel 2 at the output terminals. There. And draw the waveforms on the space provided in part 5. And that I will show in the Word file. Here are the data that I have collected in procedures 2 half-wave rectifier. The VRMS I collected from channel 1 is 6 volts. And the VP is 8.471 volts. And the FIN is equals to, the frequency in is equals to 60 Hz. And this is the oscilloscope result. And in channel 2, the VP is equal to 7.829 volts, the voltage peak. And the VDC is equal to 2.402 volts. That's what I saw in the BOM of figure 1. And moving on to procedure number 3. Full wave rectification. First step is to connect the circuit in figure 2. Second step is to connect channel 1 of the oscilloscope between the input terminals while channel 2 at the output terminals. 3. Is to draw the waveforms on the space provided in part 5. 4. Is to measure the peak input voltage and the peak output voltage. Make adjustments if necessary. 5. Is to measure the DC voltage using an analog BOM. 6. Is to measure the input and output frequency of the circuit. 7 is to connect the circuit in figure 3 naman. And we will just repeat the steps 2 to 6. So, let's go to the multisim. I will show you the figures 2 and 3. Oscilloscope, BOM, oscilloscope, BOM. The terminals is where it should be. There, figure 3, there, and And here are the data that I collected. Let's go to the Word file. In procedure 3, in the center tap circuit in figure 2, here is the data that I have collected. The VRMS is equal to 12 volts and the voltage peak is equal to 89.171 millivolts, and the frequency input in the input is 60 hertz. And in the channel 2 of the oscilloscope, the voltage peak is 5.549 volts, and the VDC that I collected from the VOM is 21.684 volts. The frequency out is equal to 60 hertz. And in waveform 4, the bridge circuit, or figure 3, the VRMS is equal to 6 volts, and the V voltage peak is equal to 8.471 volts. The frequency in is equal to 60 hertz. And in channel 2, the voltage peak is 7.189 volts, and the VDC is 2.121 volts, and the frequency out is equal to 60 hertz. And here is my conclusion. I will read it out loud. The student engineers conducted an experiment about diode application, rectification, and oscilloscope familiarization. The student engineers were able to become familiar with the functions and uses of an oscilloscope. They were able to distinguish the difference between an RMS, peak, and peak-to-peak values of an analog signal. They were able to distinguish between a halfway rectification and full-wave rectification. They also learned to measure the DC voltage converted from an AC input signal and learned how to use a multi-tap transformer. We learned that there are two types of waveforms in basic electronics. These waveforms are full waves, and the other is half waves. Full waves are from the measured voltage of the input terminal, and the half waves are waves that are measured from the output terminal. And that's it for this video. And as always, thank you for watching.